It's hard to know the age of our people when we are so easily captivated by events that have logical explanations. This would suggest that our minds have a memory of more prosperous times, and in turn, we expect more than what can actually be achieved. It is not that we are primitive in the today and now, because we are not. Our mental capacity has kept us at the top of the Earth's food chain, yet we expect to visit other worlds and meet new civilizations. The human mind stretches further into history than it will allow us to remember, and the thought here is, do we really know our own minds? Maybe for our own protection, our minds have shed memories, cut them loose like baggage that was only weighing us down. The trauma from cataclysmic events is very real in every human's mind. It is a collective trauma, and this makes us a collective species. Now, what we mean is that the thought of God, or in some traditions, the many gods, visiting us earthlings in a divine intervention in whatever circumstances is widely accepted as events that have happened. In this sense, some of us look for the answers we are told are true when our faith is tested. Fantasies like Roald Dahl depict the BFG and his intellectual offerings relating to the deeper thinking process, and the photographer Tamas Ladanyi offered the citizens of the city of Veszprem the chance to send their imaginative spurts into overdrive in 2014. Back in 2014, the photographer set a scene that would seem straight out of the film like The Day the Earth Stood Still, a stunning apparition of a seemingly giant figure in the distance that is either menacing in its presence or defensive when the citizens sleep. Cunningly named the Spectre of Veszprem, the photograph was inspired by the eerie and misty setting of the city dwellings, a beautiful image that shows the vulnerability of civilization on the Eden that is planet Earth. How was it done, we hear you ask? Well, wait till you hear this. The photographer explains that the image and scenario were taken from the top of a 20-story building with the rising sun directly at his back. The special geometry suggests this is an example of an atmospheric phenomenon called the glory, or sometimes the specter of the Brocken, also seen from mountaintops and airplanes when looking opposite the sun. This dramatic apparition is the observer's shadow on clouds or fog, the small droplets of water scattering light back towards the sun through complex internal reflections. Careful night sky watchers can also encounter this specter's analog in astronomy, a brightening of zodiacal light opposite the sun known as the gegenschein, which is a faint, diffuse brightening along the ecliptic directly opposite or counter the sun. At local midnight, 1 a.m. daylight savings time, the counterglow appears as a round to oval path of light around 8 to 10 degrees across within the zodiac constellation, crossing the southern meridian at that time. You can see it an hour or two earlier or later, but it's highest and easiest to spot during the midnight hour. As with the brighter cousin, the zodiacal light, we're seeing sunlight reflected off dust ejected by comets and released during asteroid crackups. The greater part of it is concentrated in the plane of the solar system, the reason both phenomena are centered on the ecliptic, home to the planets, moon and sun. Sunlight scattered forward off dust in the direction of the sun creates the zodiacal light. Back scattered light from dust directly opposite the sun towards the asteroid belt gives us the gegenschein. It lies opposite the sun, much like a full moon or planet at opposition. Sunlight strikes the dust particles square on. All the tiny shadows cast are hidden behind each and every grain, so they don't subtract from the belt's brightness, creating a brighter spot in the sky. The moon experiences a similar bump in brightness at the time of full phase. Astronomers call it the opposition effect. We also see the same phenomenon as a halo of light around our heads when looking at smooth or regularly textured ground with the sun at our back. And that is basically what is happening in this photograph. And we thought you guys might find that interesting and a nice change of pace. This is all from us for the moment, but we will be back just shortly with more content that is shining a light on the history of civilization as we know it. Please put your comments below, and as always, thank you for watching.